Today, I'm gonna show you how to make how I make macaroni and cheese.
English, motherfucker, do you speak it?
In a box. So here we have gochujang paste, garlic, a little bit of left kimchi. Found the short rib. And then this leftover heavy whipping cream. And I guess I got some milk. Gonna start by boiling our pasta. A little bit of oil. Next we got our short rib, it's beef. Just gonna boil it for like, not like 45 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes. Just gonna boil it with some water. Probably not gonna add salt. Usually cheese has a lot of salt, pretty salty as it is, so I'm just gonna be like, try not to use as much as possible.
Oh yeah.
And cover it and just let it go. Let that go on high heat. When it starts boiling, you'll drop the knob to medium and just let it go. Make sure you set a timer. Don't let that shit overcooked. Well, that's all going. Gonna chop some garlic, man. I don't get why people use like 3 or 1 clove of garlic. I like to use like at least 3 whole garlics. Just the whole thing. Garlic is awesome. Garlic fries, garlic burger, garlic bread, garlic pasta, garlic beer. It's simple to make mac and cheese. I mean, the instructions are on a box. They got the time and everything. But just make sure you're always stirring your pasta. You want it to evenly, cook evenly, and just not like stick to the bottom and scorch. It's kind of gross. All right, it's been 8 minutes. Got to drain the noodles right here. Bada bing, bada boom. You wanna cool it down, run it through cold water so it stops cooking. Because if you don't cool it down, it's just gonna keep cooking. You don't want mush, you know, like mushy ass fucking pasta. Yeah. Now we're gonna add some butter. Gonna work on our cheese sauce separately. So they come with these packets right here, and we're just gonna use like almost half of that. If you use the whole thing, it's like eating a whole bag of salt. It's like fucking, I don't know. Add our chunky ass fucking garlic. Who doesn't want a whole mouth of garlic? Just add it in. Make sure you're stirring it every now and then. Our rib started boiling, so I'm gonna take the cover off. Drop it down on medium.
I got my donkey.
Donkey! Donkey! This one is just good to just sip and, you know, like candy on top, like it's a deal breaker, bro. You know what I'm saying? Woo! So the guy that showed me, that got me into drinking like this, is his name's Nate. And he's the lead singer of Makoso's. And me and him would just do pozole nights and have our boy Josh, the guitarist. We would just like party, you know? Nate found me under a bridge with a bunch of punks. I was barefoot because I was from Hawaii. And so I didn't think, I thought I was invincible. Just stepping on glass. What it looks like has that like that attitude of I don't give a fuck. Like I'm still gonna be great type of deal. We got our gochujang paste. You're gonna add like 2 spoonfuls in there. Actually, we'll do 3, just in case. Kind of just going off the limb here. It's my first time doing this. See how this goes. I'm gonna add some paprika, some cumin. Just a little bit. It's pretty
flavors are pretty strong in there. On low, just let the flavors kind of bloom out. When it starts cooking, the paste is gonna get kind of like tight. You wanna just keep stirring it up so it doesn't like crisp to the bottom. Some people just put a shitload of oil and just fucking cook it like that. I'm just like, dude, you can just mix it, you know? Just.
Music. Usually I'm pretty old school. I like 90s stuff, you know, punk stuff. Grew up with like, my first record was Let's Go, Rancid. It was epic. Got deep into that and just never got out. I mean, 20 years later, I'm still rocking out.
Now we're gonna add the heavy whipping cream, because I need to use it up. I'm gonna add some milk in there. I'm gonna cheese sauce right here. I haven't added the powder yet. I'm about to add it once it starts. Usually I add the powder once it starts boiling, like, once it starts looking like a mosh pit in there, that's when you just add like half of this packet right here. Kind of want to let it cook down for a bit so you get the flavors out. You know what I'm talking about? You want the paste to kind of bloom out, and you also want the milk to kind of reduce and just get kind of that flavor with the garlic and everything. Now we got our powder, just half of it. Kind of want to stir it in a little bit so it doesn't really clump up. Because if you let it clump up, you're just going to get like a mouthful of just powder. It's fucking gross. Sprinkle, sprinkle. Tickle, tickle. Got our beef right here. It's been like 35 minutes. That's done. We're going to do a little reverse sear. I'm going to sear it in a little bit of sesame oil. Drop some regular oil in there. Sesame oil is pretty strong, so I don't really like to use like the whole thing. You just use it just to sear bone. It's all about balance, you know? Don't want to overpower the flavor of the meat itself and the bone marrow itself. Some good ass shit. Letting our pan get hot. Got some garlic salt and pepper. Season the rib with, because this is like the main. This is pretty much what you need for any seasoning. Like, this is all you need right here. Tip. You want to rub it around so the oil gets all the way through. Once it gets like golden brown, you're good to go. It's already cooked and boiled, man. You know, just take your time cooking, man. Enjoy it. Have a beer. Listen to some punk tunes. My go-to is like, I like instant food. I like doing like weird stuff with it. Street food. I like Asian food. Fusions. I don't know about like the burrito, that's kind of weird. I like pho by itself. We kind of deglaze the browning of the meat, so we're just gonna pop this right here. Boom. Add some soy sauce, add like a pinch of sugar. Now that it's it reduced, all the liquid and the sugars will coagulate and it'll just make like a nice reduction. And just toss this back in there. Kind of like let the juices go on there. Now, last but not least, got some Italian style breadcrumbs. I mean, I tried it, it's pretty good. I'd fuck with it. Some sesame seeds. Make sure it doesn't burn. Beautiful thing, man. Oi. Walk away for a fucking second. Don't be that guy. Don't be that guy. All right, no cap. We're gonna try this again.
Yeah. Okay, mister. All right, the show's over now. You put that thing away. Now put it down before you poke some.
All right, there you go. Showed you how to make a box mac and cheese, how to make drinks, how to burn stuff. Hope you had a great time. Cheers. Ah.